This tutorial will show how to insert a Google Calendar onto a web page in Google Sites. Here I am in my Google Sites, and I'm on a web page using the default web page template, and I'd like to insert a Google Calendar onto my page for my audience. So to do this, I'm going to come up to the menu bar in Google Sites and choose Insert. I'm going to come over to the Google heading and choose Calendar. Google Sites will now scan and find my Google Calendar app and all the calendars that I currently have access to from that app. I then check off the calendar I'd like to embed or display on my website. We'll use this calendar as an example. Notice that you can paste the web address from a Google Calendar here if you have access to it. Once you've made your selection, I'm going to click Select, and now I come to the configuration screen where I can specify the height and width of the calendar if I choose, what the default view will be, whether it will be month, week, or agenda view, the time zone, which is always good to set. For us, we are GMT minus 5 Eastern Time, New York. And then finally, there are display options. Would you like your audience to be able to see the week, month, and agenda tab so that they can change the view? A calendar name? Do you want the navigation buttons visible? The current date range? A border? And a title? Once you've made your choices on this page, click the Save button, and the calendar has now been inserted into your web page. Notice that by default, the calendar is not visible while you're in editor view. This is so that if you click on the widget, you can align the calendar, define text wrapping tools, go back into the properties of the calendar to make changes, or remove the calendar altogether. To test the calendar out to see what it would look like for your audience, come up to the top and click the blue Save button. Now you're viewing the calendar the way your audience would view it. To go back and make changes, click the Editing tool, click on the calendar, and then click the gear to enter the calendar properties. Notice that you have the option to display more than one calendar within this tool. I can click the Display Another Calendar option here and actually select another calendar from my calendar app. We'll use this calendar as an example. And both calendars are now listed at the top and will be defined by these two different colors. If you move your cursor to the very end of the bar, there is a small disclosure triangle where you can specify the colors you'd want to differentiate between the two calendar options. We'll make them stand out a lot. We'll click Save, and Save again. And now you see I have a calendar displaying two different items on the same calendar. It may be advisable that you provide on your website a legend or key so that your audience will know which color corresponds exactly to which calendar entry. So, in review, to insert a calendar, use the Insert tool in Google Sites so that Google Calendar options are visible. Check off the calendar or calendars you'd like to embed. Choose your settings. And choose Save. This concludes this tutorial.